Welcome to Real Estate Radio Live, an informative and engaging podcast discussing everything you need to know about the world of real estate. Your host, Joe Cacera, provides you with insight and guidance on how to buy, sell, finance, and invest in real estate. He also offers real estate tax management strategies, new construction advice, home improvement tips, and much, much more. And now, to guide you around the world of real estate, here's your host and Real Estate Radio Live team leader, Joe Cacera.
Welcome in, Joe Cacera with Real Estate Radio Live. Thank you for those that are joining us live on Facebook. We appreciate that very much. We want to continue to grow the audience in any way, most any way we can. Obviously, social media platforms are growing and the access to those. And we are a podcast, however, so if you're watching the show and you haven't yet downloaded the podcast, please do that when you get a chance. You go to iTunes and just type in Real Estate Radio Live, or you go anywhere on the internet for that matter and just type in Real Estate Radio Live, find the podcast, download the podcast. That way you could listen to it at your convenience. We have this video I want to continue to mention. We do the live feed on Facebook. And so if you're listening to the podcast later, I need to remind those listeners on a more of a regular basis to reference back, go back to Facebook, and every once in a while watch the feed, the show on video, because that's a good way to follow the show and pick up some stuff. Sometimes we do some demonstrations as well. So for more information, you go to reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. All right, today we're back. It's been a couple of weeks with schedule changes, and we're back with our friends at Barastone, and the topic is accessing wealth without debt, accessing home wealth without debt. Most of you have been following the show for the last several months. You know that this is a real hot topic, so to speak, because it's just another option that a lot of people don't know about, but it's our job to educate. Most of you know this show for 8 years. That's what we've been doing, education and information. We're big proponents of getting as much education and information as we can to you, the consumer, so that you could digest it, look into it, do your own due diligence, you know, look into whatever you're doing in terms of real estate, but we want to be the source to do that. So want to continue doing that. So welcome in, Mark. Good to have you back.
Good morning, Joe. How are you today?
Good. Doing good. So we're going to remind you a little bit about the program, what it's about. We're going to get started as we always do, just to let Mark give us a little bit of a background and then how they get started and then an overview of the program, and then we'll launch into some of our talking points.
Thanks, Joe. At Barastone, we work with homeowners to help them maximize their home wealth. Homeowners have had the great fortune of seeing their equity grow in their homes and want to get access to that equity for various reasons. And a lot of them cannot qualify for a loan or don't want to take out more debt. One of the great things about our product is it's not debt. So you can solve debt problems with our product. You can't solve a debt problem with more debt.
Right, right.
So we allow homeowners to get up to 20% of their home's value in cash in exchange for sharing in the future appreciation if the house goes up in value, or if the house goes down in value, the investor is going to participate in that decrease. So homeowners can get the cash now, use it for whatever purpose, and we have products that range from 10-year terms, 20-year terms, 30-year terms. Mm-hmm. So we really work with the homeowners to understand their needs and match the perfect product to them. Homeowners have used this product for lots of reasons. We've seen a lot of people now that have run up in the last 5-6 years their credit card debt.
Mm-hmm.
We've seen a lot of people now that are struggling to pay that, with interest on credit card debt being anywhere from 20 to 29%. That's a big amount of to pay if you have a sizable amount of debt. And a lot of times what happens is the more credit card debt you have, as you know, Joe, your credit score then gets
right.
impacted. Once your credit score gets impacted, the availability of conventional loans mm-hmm. goes away. We can help them by getting the cash now. They can pay off all that credit card debt, and we work with them to understand how to manage their debt problem so that it doesn't come back. And then in a few years, if they want, they can refinance the home and take out our product. So we've had several people recently that have done that. We had someone that did this product 3.5 years ago. They had paid off all their credit card debt. They got back on sound financial footing. They just refinanced their house, and they got a great rate and took out the amount that they owed on our product, and they're very, very happy.
Yeah. There's a lot of good options and resources and ways you could use the funds here. We're going to get into more details of that, but I always like to remind the listeners and the people that are viewing the show via Facebook right now, that just kind of an update. I always like to remind everyone kind of the traditional forward mortgages so that we understand the difference and why this is such a great option for people. Most of us know if we've bought a home or refinanced a home, if we know anything about property, typically we'll leverage the home, we'll purchase a home and get a mortgage. And that mortgage has an interest rate, and there's a cost to that interest rate. For instance, if it's a 4%, there's a 4% cost. You make a monthly payment. Typically, it's a principal and interest payment. And most of those are amortized for 30 years. It could be 30-year fixed. There could be different amortized short-term loans. Typical, the one most of us are familiar with, the 30-year fix, some of the 15. And then there's some ARM products, which is adjustable mortgage rates that some of us are familiar to, too. Those are forward paying mortgages. Those are liens against your property. You make your payments and everything's good. But remember, that's a liability. It's on your property and you have to make a monthly payment. And you can't default on those. If you do, you not only suffer with your credit, but it could be a very expensive venture for a long time. And then most of you are familiar, maybe if you have a home or you know about properties with home equity lines, this is something that typically people will go in second position. They put on their home, and they use it for emergencies, or they use it for, you know, maybe they want to do a remodel or an add-on, or some even use it for student debt. A number of different things to use it for. It's basically an equity line of credit, and those are adjustable interest rates. The things you have to be careful about with those are adjustables, and the program is 10 years, and it seems like a long time. But I know Mark's experienced this with some recent clients, and I have too, where next thing you know, that 10 years creeps up on you. So one of the things I'd like to do for those listening to the show now, whether it's you or you pass it along to your parents, friends, coworkers, have them take a look at their home equity line of credit. If you've had it, you may be surprised. It may recast in a while. It seems really nice when you have these things and you have a couple $100,000 on them, your payment's $300 or $400 a month. You're thinking, this is not too bad. That's because it's on an interest-only loan. You're not paying any principal, and it's based on a 30-year amortization. When these loans recast and come due, then this is the shock that people get that a lot of them don't remember. And even though it's all in the paperwork and you sign the documents and their disclosures, but it's easy to forget. In some cases, these payments could go up 3, 4, 5 times because it adjusts and it reamortizes. So it could be expensive venture, and it could be a surprise to most people, so keep an eye on that. The other thing is you might be familiar with reverse mortgage. This is the other way to access, you know, capital from your home. Again, these are very, very expensive, and they are a great, great program for the right person. And you notice that when we have these shows, whether it's me, Mark, my guests, we talk about these options and them being right for the right person, because it's not one fits all. Just like a reverse mortgage is not meant for everybody in this product or a 30-year fix, you have to really find out what is the best for your client and go through that evaluation process. So the reverse mortgage is really kind of the last one, that a way for people to access capital for the home, but just because you don't have a monthly payment, that actually builds up equity. Reverse mortgage is just what it says. So that every time a month goes by, that principal builds and builds and builds. And there's mortgage insurance on that, too, which is pretty expensive. So it's just things you need to know. That's why this program that Mark's talking about is very unique, in that there is no monthly payment. There is no appreciation in terms of a loan building, building, and building. If Mark's company gives you $200,000, that's a future agreement on the equity growth of your property. It does not have anything to do with a loan on your property that's growing every single month. Talk a little bit about that difference, because that is a distinctive difference, Mark.
That's a major difference. Loans are fixed right in their rate. So whether your house goes up in value or down in value, you're going to pay that interest on that loan. Our product, since it's an investment product, mm-hmm. is a variable liability. What that means is that the money you take you'll owe that back plus or minus the change in your home price movement. So if your house goes up in value, you're going to share some of that with the investor. The homeowner will also participate in that increase. But most importantly, if your house goes down in value, the investor is going to participate in that decrease. So if your house does not appreciate significantly or goes down in value, you may owe the same or less back than you originally did. With a conventional or reverse mortgage, if your house doesn't go up in value or goes down in value, the compounding effect of the interest rate will eat away at some, or if not, in a lot of cases, all of the equity. Reverse mortgages have their place, but if you have to pay off an existing mortgage with it, it could become very aggressive in terms of eating away at your equity. An investment product like ours, or all the products we have, are variable in nature. So we've seen a great rise in home prices over the last 5 to 10 years. A lot of people believe we're at or near the top of the market. So this might be a great time to do a product like this where your house may not go up in value as much as it has over the last 10 years.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's talk about some of the inner workings of the program, Mark. And, you know, let's just talk about the things people are using, the way they could use them for. First, there's no age requirements of course, I guess, 18, right?
Correct. You have to be of legal age to sign a contract.
Right.
But there's no age requirement. You can be of any age. The qualification is really based on the amount of equity you have in the house. So if you have a substantial amount of equity, usually greater than 50%, and in some cases, even if you had 30% of equity, we can work with that. But typically, people have been in their house for a while, and with the increase in value, they have 50% equity. In that case, that's the focus. Credit score, we have programs that don't take into effect credit score because you're using this problem to solve the problem that caused your credit score to go down.
Right.
We see people that once they do our product, their credit scores may be in the 500s. They take this out, they pay off all that credit card debt, they're now on time with their payments, their credit score has gone up to 700.
Right.
That's a big difference. The loan, you know, your debt to income, the typical ratios that loans look at can be very customized here, where homeowners don't have to have that 40% debt to income. So if your income is enough, if you have a mortgage, the main thing that we look for is, do you have enough capital, monthly income to pay off that mortgage? And if you don't, then we can look to qualify you based on the amount of money you get. So if you get, 20% on a $1 million house or $200,000, and you're paying off debt maybe $50,000, $75,000, you're gonna have $125,000 cushion that we can look to say, okay, they have enough to make sure they'll make their mortgage payments and make sure that their financial future is bright. In terms of what people have used the money for, I mentioned paying off credit card debt. We've had people use it for college education. A lot of places in the country, it's very expensive to live, and people fall behind on saving for their kids' education. This is a great way to catch up. Use the money to pay for their education because the kids are going to get it in the end. Give it to them now when they need it most. We've had people use it to supplement a business. A lot of small business owners are looking for expansion capital. They may not have the ability to get a business loan, or they do not want to take out an additional mortgage on their property, which if something happened to the business, they'd be saddled with. There's a lot of life events happen. We work with divorced couples where one of the parties wanted to stay in the house but needs capital to buy out the other person. And we've done several of those where one of the spouses ended up with the house. They got enough money to pay off the other spouse.
One of the things I want to talk about that may be unpopular to some people, but it actually bothers me, and that sometimes we live in this, what's tried to be this politically correct society. But I'll tell you, in this business, the last 20 years that I've been in, I see a lot of people that get to be in their 60s, 70s, 80s, and older. They've owned their home for 30, 40, 50-plus years. They may not have any pension. They have Social Security. It's a very limited. Most of you know what Social Security covers, very little. They may not have had a job or a circumstance that they have a lot of investment retirement. But you know what's unfortunate, Mark, I want to talk a little bit about this today, is that, you know, it's still frowned upon. And as much as I appreciate financial planners out there, if you're listening to this, this is to you. You want to encourage people to invest. So, of course, that's a smart thing to do. I believe in it. You believe in it. I think most people would. However, when they invest, you, the financial planner, that institution is making money on that money, which is okay. This is a capitalist society. We're all good. That's good. I'm not painting a negative. What I'm saying is, it's so funny how some people will frown on people who own that home and invest that home for 50 years, but they'd rather have them liquidate their 401k or go into debt versus, Mark, pull money out of their home, their investment, without a payment. This bothers me to a certain extent, and that's why it's important to get this information out. Because we have to change the way we think, and especially for these people that are in their home, and in some cases, they're emotionally paralyzed. They're scared to make a decision, and I don't blame them. And people would say, don't do anything with that home. You've paid your home off. Well, it's easy for someone to say that's out having fun every day and going about their life. But if they're sitting in their house, Mark, and I'm not being dramatic. This is real, right? And they're afraid to make a move because they can't do anything. They can't take a vacation. They can't fix the roof in some cases. They can't enjoy their life because they feel like they're locked up in this equity.
Well, one of the one of the most important things for a financial planner when they look at someone's assets is diversification.
Right.
So when a homeowner goes to a financial planner and shows them their assets, they look at their cash, their stocks, their bonds, and they look at that as a finite group and say, okay, now we got to diversify that. Unfortunately, for most Americans, that represents only about 30% of their net worth.
Right.
70% is tied up in their house. And what we are trying to do is expand the definition of diversification to include that home wealth. And the reason that financial planners could never look at that is because they couldn't do anything with
it.
Now you have alternatives. These are investment products. It's not a loan. So a financial planner can't encourage the homeowner to take a loan on their home. But this is an investment product.
Right.
And so the homeowner can do our product and understand how that changes their investment diversification and their investments that they have. We had a homeowner that, you know, had $200,000 in cash, stocks, and bonds and was looking to do our product. They got about $300,000 out of our product. Combine that with their initial savings. Now they have $500,000. They've increased their liquid holdings 150%. Mm. And now diversifying that $500,000. And so their overall diversification becomes really a much better financial plan for them than having 70-80% tied up in the equity in their house. There's 30% of Americans that have zero savings outside of their home.
Yeah. And I want to make sure I'm clear that I'm not suggesting that everybody run out and pull equity out of from home and then go some do some crazy things with it. And I think most people that listen to this show, they know me and they understand, but I just want to make sure I'm clear. I'm not suggesting, you know, people go pull out a bunch of equity and go blow it and go to Vegas and gamble or whatever. Of course, you could do whatever you want. I'm saying that there is a segment of people in this population, I see it every day, that are house rich, cash poor. And it's sad because they can't take a vacation. They can't go visit their grandchildren. They can't. And this is not dramatic. This is real. And the reason why is because they have all their equity locked up in the home. And traditionally, most people will say, don't touch the house. Don't touch the home. And again, this is where there's guidance. You have to find people in your... You know, if you're listening to this show, and it may not affect you, but you might be thinking of a parent, aunt, uncle, grandparent, they should be considering this with, as a group, as a family, and obviously doing their due diligence. Because one of the things that's gone on in the past, Mark, and that we want to make sure we're painting a different picture, is unfortunately senior citizens, in this case, if we're talking about that segment or that generation, have been taken advantage of, and there's a lot of scams that take place with senior citizens, right?
Absolutely.
So you have to be careful with that.
And really, it's an education process.
Right.
Really, we're trying to educate people on what this product is and how it helps homeowners. Typically, the philosophy has always been pay off your house, have no debt, because you know there's no risk if you can't make your mortgage payment.
Right.
The difference with these alternative-type products or investment products is once you do it, you have no obligation to make a monthly payment. There's no interest on it. It only comes to pass when you sell the home,
right,
or when the last surviving
right
title holder passes away. So the risk that people were always worried about taking out a loan,
mm-hmm,
I got to make that monthly payment. If I don't make that monthly payment, they're going to come and foreclose on my house. With these products that we have, that never happens.
Right.
You know, once the homeowner gets the cash, they may never interact with the investment
mm-hmm
company for 30 years.
Right.
So there's no risk. You know, when we had a client take the money out to put into their startup venture company, they needed $250,000. They were out looking at investors. The investors wanted to take too much of the company. They had great credit. They
mm-hmm
could have taken out a loan. But what he said to me was, I can do your product and have peace of mind knowing that if something goes wrong with my startup company and
right
it doesn't make it, I don't have monthly payments on your product, and I can, it just sits
mm-hmm
there until we sell the house.
Yeah. Now, it's a great program, but again, we encourage you, if you're listening to the show, you're watching the show, and you think it might have someone that applies to, we have just a couple minutes here, just reach out. And Mark, Steve can answer any questions, by the way, if anybody's interested in finding out more. What's the best way to reach you guys?
You can go to our website at barastone.com, that's BARASTONE.com, or give us a call, 650-802-0800. We'd be happy to chat with you. There's no obligation. We can look at your situation, understand it. We offer a home wealth report to homeowners to help them understand what their options are and ways to maximize their home wealth. So give us a call. More than happy to have myself, Steve, or anyone else understand your situation and see what the best option is for you.
Yeah. Before I forget, I should have done this at the beginning of the show, but we always want to remind you, those that listen to this show is brought to you by Bundle Select. So if those don't know about Bundle Select, if you're listening to the show or watching the show and you're an employee of a company, this should interest you, or take this to your HR people, your HR manager. Bundle Select is an employee real estate platform. It's no cost to your company or the employee. It's getting a lot of traction. We've signed up companies like Adobe, Garden Health, and many others. We're excited about it. So again, if you're an employee and you're looking for a benefit that's going to add value or give you a competitive advantage, share this with your HR people. If you're an HR person anywhere in talent acquisition listening to this show, you want to learn more, go to bundleselect.com. That's bundleselect.com. All right, Mark, thanks. Good to have you on. So we'll have you back next week. Again, for those that want to reach out and more information, just give your contact one more time.
Great. Thanks, Joe. Give us a call at 650-802-0800 or visit our website at barastone.com.
Very good. Thanks. This
Thanks.
Is Joe Kuchera with Real Estate Radio Live. Thanks again for tuning in. Thank you for those that are watching us on Facebook. If you want more information, you could always go to the website. That's RERadiolive.com. Take care. Have a great afternoon.
You've been listening to Real Estate Radio Live. For more information on today's program, visit RERadiolive.com. That's RERadiolive.com. Subscribe to our podcast. Discover more at RERadioLive.com.